Hey guys, welcome back to another African dance class. As I said last week, today we're going to be dancing to the song World by Olamide. If you are new here, my name's Abby, and I'm your African dance teacher. Okay, so like I did last week, I'm going to try to teach the moves both with counts and with lyrics. So I'll just be switching between the two. And before I start teaching, I'm just going to go and show you what the dance is like beforehand.
Jiang Jiang, the wicked producer.
Exactly when the beat drops. So the first dun you hear is exactly when you start. So you'll hear dun, 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 dun. You'll hear four of those, and each time you first start on your left, then you go on your right, then left, right. So you switch each beat you hear, and every time your arms go down, so they're up like this, almost like they're framing your face, but they're a little lower, closer to your chest. So as you step, before you step, your arms are up here, but when you step, they go down like this. So it looks like this. One, two, three, four. And make sure your feet are like hip width apart. So after you hear those four beat drops, you start to speed up just as the beat speeds up. So you do the exact same thing with your hands and your feet, but except you have more steps to go with the beats. So to begin, you have dun, 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 but then it speeds up and it goes dun, 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 dun. And then you do that four times as well. And after you've done all eight of your steps, you bring your right foot in, almost like we did last week with the guara guara, but instead of like putting your arms with it, you just move your legs by themselves. So it goes one, two, three, four, and you'll hear it in the beats that it progresses and it gets faster and faster, so your legs just match the beat. So it goes one, two, three, four, like that. So for the beginning, if we put it together, you have dun, 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 dun. And then after you move your legs in, so you go one, two, three, four. You do it four times, and each beat you alternate. After you do that, you swing your arms back behind you with your knees bent a little. You swing your arms back, and you hop forward, just like that. And you do that when he says, whoa, the first time. So you've just done one, two, three, four, one, two, like that. And you land with your arms by your side and your feet still again, like shoulder width apart. So we can put that together with music really quickly to see how, so you get a sense of how quick it is.
Jiang Jiang, the wicked producer.
You saw, as I just did before, you start exactly when that beat starts, and you end like this when he says whoa. So after you've ended like this, you take your right arm and you go like this. So you go from corner down beside you, and you do the same with your left after. You go corner to your side. And with your feet, when you move your right hand up, you step your left foot out and put your right foot together. So it looks like this, one, two. And then you do the same with the other side. So you go one, two, three, four. You only do that twice. You only hit each side once. So after you've done one, two, three, four, you do a move called the shoki. So what you do is you turn face this side, and you put your right hand out, and your left hand comes across your body like this, and they're on two different levels. Your right hand is lower than your left hand, and you just come down into a spot like this, and rise like that. So you kind of like move like a snake when you come up. So you just turn face this side, and you come one, two, three, four. And as you come up, your legs, your left leg is moving in and out like this. One, two, three, four. So let's start from, without the music, let's start from when you first jump. So the beat has gone faster. Da-da-da-da-da. Oh yeah, whoa. And you go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So after you shoki and you come up, you put both hands out like this, your palms flat open, and you put your right leg up. So your leg is at a 90 degree angle. So your arms are up like this, and you go one, you kick out, two, kick out, three, kick out, four, kick out. So you kick out four times, and each time you kick out, you're facing a different direction. And as you kick out, your hands go, they open and close, almost like fireworks when they go off. So it's like one, two, three, four. And really use your standing leg as like support and strength to get you to the other sides. So you've just ended like this. You put your right leg that was up, you put it down so it's in front of you, so you're almost like in the shape of an A, and you put your you take your right hand and you blow out like this. So it's almost like, you know, you're like whatever. So you blow out like this, and make sure you like blow with your mouth, so almost like you're blowing powder. So you've just ended like this, whoa, and you just did one, two, three, four, shoki, 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 and you hit, out, blow. So when you drop your leg that's been up, you drop your leg and you blow at the same time. So it's like one, like that. So we can do that from the top with music.
Young John, the wicked producer.
So it's just that quick. When you blow out, you can, if you want to, you can like bend your left leg with it and have your toes be the only thing on the ground, so your heel is up. You can do that, that's optional. It's really whatever your preference is. So after you've ended like this, kind of like in last week's dance where, you know, you drag your hips and your hands follow, you do the same thing. So what you do, you end it like this. So you step again with your right leg and you drag to face the side, just like that. So if you remember last week's, we did the same thing, but we did it in shorter movements. This one is just one long one. And you just swivel to face the other side. And now your left leg will be in front. Okay, so you just hip swivel to this side. Make sure that your legs are in a neutral position, so like hip width apart, and your legs are even, so not one foot is not in front of the other. And you take your right hand, and almost like in a, you're drawing a circle in the air, you hit the ground in front of you with a flat palm like this. So when you are moving your right hand in a circle, your left hand is by your side like this, but make sure that it also is moving in a circle but in the opposite direction, so it ends up like this when you're on the ground. So for example, it should look like that. So after you hit the ground here, and if it's difficult for you to hit the ground with a flat palm with at a neutral position, you could always like readjust your legs so you are able to hit the ground. So after you've made it down here, what you do is you take your right hand or your right arm almost in a circle, and you almost like you take your right leg and you like trip over yourself, if that makes sense. So you're like this, and you're like this. left arm comes back the way that it was. So instead of completing the circle like this, you just, you are like this, and you just go back. So basically you take the shortest route to get back to your side. So once you're like this, you take your right leg and place it behind your left leg, and you do the same, and then you put your right leg back out and place your left leg behind your right leg. And it's and the way you do it is almost like you're tripping over yourself, I would say. So basically, after you've already made it to this position, what you do is you take the shortest route so your arm makes it back to your side. So instead of completing the circle around like this, you go the other direction. So once you do that when you do almost like a trip step. So what you do is your right leg goes behind your left leg, and your left leg comes up like this, and then you go back to a neutral position, and then your left leg goes behind your right leg comes up like your left leg did. So as you are doing that, your arms are doing a windmill, I guess you could call it. So you just come up like this, and your arms go like this, or actually, you just come up like this, and your arms go like this. So I guess your right hand, or your right arm and your left arm are going in two different directions. So your right arm is going counterclockwise, and your left arm is going clockwise. So you just made it. You've just done your two trips. So after that, your legs are underneath your hips, so they're close together, like this. And you throw your right arm back like this. So it's like kind of at an awkward angle. You throw it back like this, like you're about to like pass a baton or something like that, or pass a baton, and your left arm follows. So you go one, two. But, and your legs for that, you lift your hip on the right side first, so it goes up, down, and you do the same with the left side, up, down. So put together, it looks like one, two, three, four. And each side, you lift your hip twice. One, two, three, four. So if we put that together from the very beginning, without music, you have your beats, and it goes one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, one, two, three. Jump, 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 flow, swivel, and grind. Trip, trip, hip, hip. So it's that quick. We can do that again one more time without music really quickly in the very beginning. So five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And that's just like that. So now we'll put it together with music.
It's Young John, the Wicked Producer.
Circles with your hands, you'll hear like a beep not even hear the beep, but just know that after you've done this twice, you should hit with your shoulders. So it goes one, two, hit, like that. And then you do the same with the other side, and it goes one, two, hit. You don't put your hands up to your shoulders, but I'm just doing it for emphasis. So if we do that again, it goes one, two, hit, one, two, hit, like that. And the legs for this part are, you're leaning your weight on your right leg, and you're doing circles, so you go one, two, hit. When you hit, your left leg comes up in the air, and your feet are pointed towards the ground. And you do the same thing with the other side, but except your left leg bears the weight, and so circles and up, so your right leg is the one that's pointed towards the ground. So if we put that together, you go one, two, hit, three, four, hit. So if we put that together from when you ended up blowing like this, you drag your hips face this side, then you hit the ground, then you trip, trip, hit, hit, lift, 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 down, out, in, out, out. You take your hand up to your forehead like we did last week, and you just move your legs in and out. So it's a one, two, three, four. Your right leg goes in. Your knee towards your leg. Left leg, knee towards leg. Knee, knee, like that. So one, two, three, four, like that. After you've done that, what you do is your arms are in fists, and your elbows are towards your body at first. And you hit your upper thigh like this. One, two, three. If I do it facing front, it looks like this. One, two, three. Really quick. So if I put that together, you just ended like on the ground like this. So you trip, trip, lift, lift, out, in, out, out. One, two, three. One, two, three. And that's it. So after you hit your thighs three times, and you do a bridge, but without one arm. So you, your right hand will be the one supporting you on the ground. So your arms are like this. You take your right hand, a circle like this, and hit the ground like that with your left hand. With your left hand in the air. Make sure your left hand is in the air, and if you can't get your bridge super high, it doesn't really matter, as long as your back is off the ground or it looks somewhat similar to what I just did. So let's piece that together. You've just gone out, in, out, out. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Right leg over left, spin to the side, and back, like that. And when you hit back with your bridge, you do it on when he says whoa. And that's how you know that's the end of the dance. So we're gonna run through that without music once, and then we're gonna do it with music twice. So from the beginning, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. In, jump back. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There is a little bit of pause, but from when you turn around and you do your bridge. So you'll hear that in the music when we do it really quick. So we're gonna do this with music really quickly right now.
Young John, the wicked producer.
Like a movie. movements, you don't really have time to go to do everything super full out, but just, you know, try your best. This is the last time we're gonna do this before you all can go home and, you know, try this by yourselves, show your friends, share, like, subscribe.
It's Young John, the Wicked Producer.
Hi, we're your IFA co-founders. I'm Ellie.
And I'm Miriam.
And thank you so much for watching our videos.
You guys can learn more about our cause down below at our website, www.inspirationfinearts.org.
And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
We couldn't be where we are without the support of you guys, so make sure to send in videos of the things that you've learned during classes and pictures of the art that you completed.
Everything you send in will be featured on all our social media platforms.
Thanks for supporting us, and until next time,
go find your inspiration!